G'day there, it's Pete Moriarty here, and in this video, I'm going to cover how you can save a bunch of time by disabling your Facebook newsfeed. Now, we're going to be covering both the mobile and the desktop, and first up, I'm going to tell you why it's so important to make sure that you are productive online. Now, we all know that it's important to manage our time, but the reason it's so important is because we only get a certain number of minutes and seconds in the day. Everyone's in the same playing field, and we're basically stuck with a limited amount of time. You can't buy more time, you can't create more time. All we can do is choose how to spend our time. And so getting good at choosing how you spend your time is going to be the thing that's going to help you be more productive and also get better results in what you do. Now, today's reality of business is that with us wanting to be thought leaders and us wanting to connect with our customers as well, it's important to have a social presence. And so it's hard to just completely switch off and say, no, I'm not going to participate in social media at all, because that just doesn't really work. You do need to have some kind of connection, but if we have stronger boundaries with the way that we're working, well, then we're going to actually have a better time and we're going to have more chances of actually staying productive and being productive. So I want to show you and tell you how to actually disable the Facebook newsfeed. And the advantage that that does is it takes away the addictive qualities of Facebook. It really takes away the part of Facebook that is the thing that keeps bringing you back and can be quite time consuming as well. It's important to read your messages. It's important to connect on notifications if you've been tagged in something. But I personally believe that moving away from the timeline feature is the number one thing that's gonna really help you out to be more productive. Now, why am I comfortable doing that? You might be thinking, Pete, aren't you gonna miss out on updates from, you know, friends and family? Are you gonna miss someone's baby being born? Yep, from time to time, I have missed important events. But what I've found is in over 6 years of having my Facebook feed completely disabled, that the important friends that I really care about keeping in touch with, I actually share precious moments with them via text message or via a message on Messenger or on WhatsApp. And so I've got other ways of connecting with people that are really important for me rather than scrolling through an endless timeline. Now, in the current economic situation that we're at, every time I try and, you know, peek back into the timeline, because yeah, sure, I do every couple of months from time to time just to see what I'm missing, I find that I'm not really missing that much. I find myself feeling at the end of the day a little bit anxious, a little bit uncomfortable, a little bit more down than I was, or a little bit more scared about the world than I was when I first unblocked it. And so I'm really happy to just completely go cold turkey and live without a newsfeed. And I'm going to share how you can do that as well. So first up, on your computer, if you're using Google Chrome, there is an amazing plugin called Kill the Facebook Newsfeed. And I'm going to drop a link to that right down below. Now, once you install that plugin, it removes the newsfeed from your Facebook. Now, in my testing, this only works with the old version of Facebook. So if you've got like a new updated layout, it may not work for you. But what that does is it removes the newsfeed scrollable feature, but still lets you use all the other features of Facebook. So you can still use your messages, you can still work with anything else that you need to do on the Facebook, as long as you're not looking for the newsfeed, because it's completely gone. Next up, it's time to get rid of it on our mobile. And what we're gonna do there is, unfortunately, because there's no timeline feature, completely delete the app. And yes, you might be wondering, well, is it a good idea to delete the app? I'm gonna miss out on updates. Well, if you've got the Messenger app and you've got the Pages Manager app to manage your business page, you shouldn't really need to spend too much time on Facebook on your phone. And what I found myself, because I've got a bit of an addictive personality, is from time to time, I would actually go to Facebook in the browser on my phone after I deleted the app just to check something. And then I'd end up getting stuck in the newsfeed as well. So I'd recommend if you're using an Android phone or an iOS device, you actually block the Facebook website using the parental controls or one of the blocker apps, and actually completely block yourself from being able to access it at all on your mobile phone. And what that means is, yes, it's a bit more inconvenient. You have to jump onto an actual computer if you want to get access to, you know, connecting to a Facebook event. So once you've blocked the newsfeed on your phone and on your computer, you can enjoy actually taking back control of your time with Facebook. And this is going to help you as a business owner spend more time either on your business or with your family or doing the things that you love and keep you away from the evils of Facebook addiction. So if you've liked this tip and you're interested in more, then you may be interested in joining our free Facebook community for business owners. Now, we're primarily working with the Google ecosystem, Gmail, Docs, and Drive. And so we do a lot of content helping business owners use Google's tools more effectively for your small business. But we also cover topics like productivity, working with your team, making sure you and the people in your life are productive, and using technology as a tool for benefit rather than feeling like you're a slave to tech in your business world. And so if you're interested in learning more about tech and getting more tips just like this one, then jump on the link below and join our group. Look forward to seeing you in there. Till the next one, cheers.